Good evening, everyone. This is Don again with Evangelism Outreach Ministries. This is December 18th, 2020. We're at the entrance to the St. Petersburg Pier in St. Petersburg, Florida. It's a very busy night. It's also very cool out here tonight. It's actually very pleasant, and we're hoping to get started here pretty soon with the proclamation of the good news of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. There's a big police presence out here, which is a good thing, to maintain law and order, and we're always delighted to be out here to see the local community and to interact with them, and with the hope that people will come to faith in Christ. And as the scripture says, it's so important to have people that go out and preach the good tidings of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what we hope to do tonight. If you think about it, if you keep us in prayer and remember us in prayer, that the Lord's will would be done. We certainly want to bring glory to Him and bring praise to His great name. And before long here, we're going to get started with Andrew preaching. And to God be the glory. I must say as well that I'm very thankful to be living in the United States these days, and that we still have freedom of speech, freedom to speak, and what a joy it is to have that in the United States. Not everybody has that around the world, and very nice to be able to speak openly and to share your faith with people. Sometimes I think that's taken for granted. Raising that, and that's all we've ever known, and yet this freedom of speech in so many ways is under fire in the world today, especially in the United States. Very sad, but it's a reality that's becoming something that we're going to have to face as we see the world change, as we see the country change, as we see socialism take more root in the country and Christianity be pushed out. We're going to find a lot of persecution directed towards the people of God, and that's to be expected. Without any further ado, here is Andrew.
I am not. Art thou?
Creator
people today will
say, what's the big deal about eating from
the big deal is God told them not to, and they did it anyway. God gave them a clear command, and they chose to disobey that command. And when we disobey one of the commands of the Lord, that is rebellion against Him, that is sin. Sin is any thought, word, or deed that we do in rebellion and disobedience to God.
build up here on earth will matter the fire. You build up here on earth. No matter the social status, you build here on earth.
Thank you.
the New Testament, Jesus would sharply rebuke them. His Jesus tied by grace that we are saved. His grace and mercy alone, not by anything that we can do. Nothing in my hands I bring, but simply to the cross I cling. Upon the children.
Now you can see an example of some spiritual warfare going on, trying to drown out the proclamation of the gospel.
Thank you. does a little bit.
All these good deeds
thank you. have to get another unit.
Yeah.
It's just not working right.
I don't know if it has to do with like everything going on or something.
Yeah, oh yeah, it's the surrounding noise.
Thank you. Jesus Christ at the end of his life. He paid the penalty. He paid the fine for those sinners and he died. He died the death that he did not deserve. He died the death of a common criminal that was in sin without him. He was beaten, he was mocked, he was covered.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. It is.
Thank you.
little maybe
I would say memorize subscription.
Okay.
We need to get some flashcards how you memorize subscription.
Oh, I got it.
How much room do you have?
A little bit.
I would say let's get some flashcards together.
Thank you. Thank you. bitching this green with no boots on the face of cancer. Aren't you just like me and she? I should like you, she don't mean that shit.
Thank you. Thank you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Today is the day of salvation. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. And all thy house. The Bible says, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in the heart, for God has made them for sin. Thou shalt be saved. But the heart man believeth.
righteousness. For they shall be filled. The question is, where do you stand tonight? Are you poor in spirit? Are you humble before God? Do you know that you are a beggar indeed of salvation? Do you know that apart from Jesus Christ the Lord, that you are destitute and you need help? Only those people that know that they are beggars, only those people that know their sinfulness, know that they need a Savior. Only those people who mourn over their sin are going to repent of their sins and get right with God. Only those people who are truly meek are going to submit themselves to Christ. For Jesus said, if any man come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. It's only the merciful that is going to obtain mercy. Jesus was merciful and is merciful. And yet, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. The only way a sinner can be filled with righteousness is to be born again from the Spirit of the living God. You are born again by the Spirit of a living God to receive a cloak, a robe of righteousness that you can't buy in any other. Think about this for a minute. There's a blessing for those people who are in Christ Jesus, a blessing that this world does not know or understand. If you want to be truly blessed, you got to get right with God. You got to go to God on His terms and repent of your sin and place your faith and trust in Jesus Christ the Lord. That's just the way it is. Thus saith the Lord. Thus saith the Lord. We as Americans don't like to be told much what to do. But when we're talking about the God of all creation that created the heavens and the earth, that created you and me, we know that God has the authority, He has the right to tell us what He expects. He has the right to expect that we repent of our sin. Why would we not want to repent of our sin? Why would anybody want to die and go to hell? This is the question, folks. If you were to die tonight, if you were to draw your last breath tonight, where would you find yourself in eternity? You see, once you draw your last breath, there's no renews, there's no do-overs. You can't come back and take life like you did wrong. What's this side of eternity? Once you draw your last breath, once your heart stops beating for the last time, know this, your eternal state is sealed. The only way you can get right with God is here on this side of eternity. It's here that God commanded all men everywhere to repent of your sins and place your faith and trust in Jesus Christ the Lord. For those people who reject the Lord Jesus, there will be certain punishment that will be doled out by God Himself on the day of judgment. There's coming a day of judgment on the last day. Those people whose names are not found written in the Lamb's book of life, the Lord God, the righteous, will say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Think about this, this is there again. No do-overs, no makeup tests. At that point, your faith will be sealed. There will be no way to go back. The rich man and Lazarus knew all about this. The rich man died. He lived it up on this side of heaven. He lived it up. He enjoyed this life. And yet when he died, he found himself in hell. And yet Lazarus was a poor man. He was a poor beggar. And he died. And he found himself in Abraham's bosom. Right there we see an example from Jesus Christ the righteous, who teaches in His Word the difference between the faith of the rich man and the faith Esau in the bosom of Abraham. And that's figurative of heaven itself. When we think about this, we know that there were two men that lived on this earth. One was rich and had everything in this world. And yet one was poor and had nothing but Jesus. The rich man died and found himself in hell. The poor man died and found himself in Abraham's bosom. Then the tables were turned and the rich man cried out and wanted to much taste of the things that Lazarus enjoyed in the bosom of Abraham. And yet there was no way for him to even taste of those things that Lazarus was enjoying. In the arms of King Jesus, this should cause us to think about ourselves. What if we were that rich man? What if we were that Lazarus? Where would we find ourselves in eternity? Think about this, folks. Think about issues of life and death. We often, as Americans, live this life as if there is no tomorrow. We live our lives without any accountability before God. We live our lives because we want to please ourselves and satisfy the lust of our own flesh. And yet, who wants to submit themselves to King Jesus? Who wants to surrender their lives to King Jesus? Well, Lazarus did. Lazarus found himself submitting himself to King Jesus. He died and found himself in the bosom of Abraham. In the bosom of Abraham, the rich man that had everything in this world found himself in hell, desiring the things that Lazarus enjoyed in the bosom of Abraham. Again, what is figurative of heaven in the arms of Jesus? Where do you find yourself tonight? Do you find yourself as that rich man who died and went to hell? Are you going to find yourself as Lazarus who one day died and find himself in the arms of Jesus? This should concern every one of us. This should concern every one of us. One day we're all going to draw our last breath. One day our hearts are going to stop and beat no more. One day we're going to lay down and never rise again. And that's true in Christ Jesus the Lord. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and dead, yet shall he live. You see, there is a hope for the people that believe on Jesus Christ alone. For those people who are vividly born again by the Spirit of the living God, there is hope for them. You know that the grave is not the end of the story. You know that there's coming a resurrection. You know that one day Jesus is coming again to receive his people unto himself. That where he is, there will his people be with him forever and ever and ever. You see, one day this heaven and this earth will be no more. One day this earth is going to give up all the dead, which is going to be brought before God in judgment. God is going to judge the quick and the dead. Those people whose names are not written in the Lamb's book of life will be punished by God with eternal torment in the lake of fire. I don't know about you tonight, but I like fire, and I'm looking for this. But I don't want to be cast into that fire. I don't want to be cast into that fire. Why would anybody want to be cast into the lake of fire? But many Americans today boast about fire. They boast about the lake of fire. They boast about hellfire. You think that it's a game. Let me tell you something, you won't be saying that on the other side of eternity. Thank you.
close this out? With the camera?
Oh, sure.